We were too late. Again. I saw it. I knew it would happen.
Shulk.
Why? Why did this have to happen?
Father.
Melia, the hope of our people. You must not cry.
Don't say that. I don't care how improper it is. Let me cry.
Melia.
Why does it have to be me? If all it takes is to be half Homs.
Is that what you think? You are very much mistaken.
But...
to become the hope of the High Entia is a fate that you choose for yourself. As long as you remember this, it is certain that you will be worthy of that name. But remember this also. It is not because you are the hope of the High Entia that I love you. It is because I love you, and I wish for you to become that hope. Heir to the Monado, I leave the sword in your hands. The sword that my forefathers sealed away. With it, you can succeed.
Your Majesty.
Melia, cry for as long as you must. But when your tears are dry...
Melia, come with me.
Shulk, I...
You'll have plenty of time to think about your empire and your people's hopes. If you need me, I will be at your side. But you are an individual. You are Melia Antiqua. And you can't let them get away with this.
You're right. My foremost concern is making them pay.
Well played indeed, Zanza.
I do what is necessary for the world.
I could very easily have stood in for you.
Your sentiment is appreciated. I see a storm on the horizon.
And finally, Crown Princess Melia's accession will take place 1 year from today. Until such time, as decreed by the Crown Princess, I shall assume imperial duties as regent. If there is anyone who objects to said decision, state your grievances now.
All the ministries are unanimous. We have no objection to Her Majesty's decree.
To each and every one of you, our thanks.
If I may, Your Highness, I would like to propose a roundtable discussion on strategy concerning the Mekon.
Ah, what to do about the Mekon? Our defenses must be shored up immediately.
Not only our defenses, Your Highness.
Do you suggest an offensive approach? While the capital still licks its wounds?
The Ministry of Research has the ideal solution.
Friends act strange. A friend sad? Oh, Ricky sad too, because of empty belly.
Ricky, we already ate. Us Homs don't get upset just because we're hungry.
Not hungry? Oh, Hom must have small bellies. Oh, Ricky jealous.
We've got to get our minds off this somehow. Dunban's locked himself away ever since we came back. Is it because of the girl who was operating that mech on?
Melia. How are you?
What do you mean? If you were talking about Father, I'm fine. I have no choice but to look to the future.
You're stronger than me, Melia.
Do not mock me. More importantly, it is time you tell me who she is.
We've known her all our lives. We thought she was killed in Colony 9.
She didn't even recognize us. She's not the Fiora I remember.
It looked a lot like Fiora. But if it was her, then I can't imagine how Dunban feels.
What did he mean?
Fiora is Dunban's sister.
I didn't know. Is this Fiora important to Shulk?
Important? She's more than important. She's the reason we're out here.
If that really was Fiora, why didn't she reply to me? Fiora. I'd better talk to Dunban. He'll know something.
Hey everyone, ArchTalko here, welcoming you back to Xenoblade. Guys, if you haven't seen the previous episode, my god, what are you doing? So much has happened, and there's so much that I want to go over and talk about in-depth-wise with what happened with the story, because honestly, with that amount of cutscenes, I just literally wasn't able to get many words in about what was happening. Please check it out before watching this. I mean, I really shouldn't have to say that, but I figured I should anyway. So, we have a trek here. Our mission today is to seek out Dunban and talk with him about what happened, which we are going to get to in time. Believe me, it will happen. But while we're on our way there, there's a lot I want to go over, and honestly, it's probably going to be like what happened after the whole Zord surprise attack, and then the whole confrontation with Metalface outside of the Aether Mine. So I apologize, there's probably just not going to be a whole lot happening for a while. I hope you guys can bear with me, because I have a lot to say. Now, I think it's like right over there is where we'll find Dunban, but for now, we're just going to hang out. We're going to make this kind of pretty. Let me, Let's frame that. Oh, yeah. Oh, perfect. Perfect. And with that, let's begin. The first thing that I really want to talk about is Sorean. I know I've already said this plenty of times previously, but I love Sorean. I feel like he's a brilliantly written character, and for that reason, I both love and just hate him. Here's why, right? At his core, Sorean is one of the most kind and warm, compassionate people in this game. Like, there's just nothing but kindness and warmth emanating from him. But the problem is that he's also High Entian, and he's basically the High Entian to end all High Entia. You know, he's the emperor of these people. And part of the High Entia is that they hide their emotions. They're very cold on the surface. They're very keen to just bury away any kind of warmth and feelings, which I feel definitely contrasts to how Sorean actually is. But I feel like, especially as his role as the leader of these people, that High Entian side of him, that tendency to be cold on the outside, is so strong that Melia literally went her entire life with so little self-worth and just so little confidence in herself that until basically the moment that Sorean died, Melia didn't really believe that he loved her, or at least didn't love her because she was his daughter. He only loved her. Sorry, I'm getting my pronouns all mixed up. Because of her heritage, because of her half-Hom's bloodline, which she still wasn't and isn't. We aren't totally aware of why that is so critical, why that's so important. And it makes me feel so sad. That moment where Sorean is just confessing how much she means to him, how much hope and faith he has in Melia as the successor and as the leader of the High Entian people, it always just makes me feel some things, man. Oh, you want to talk about those hashtag dem feels? That is the scene right there that just gets to me. I love it to death, but I hate it because it's so sad that Melia hadn't realized his love for her until his dying breath. But in a culture where half-Homs aren't really treated that well, where there's essentially like inherent racism towards them, in a culture where Melia is the only royalty that is required at all times to be wearing a mask to hide her identity whenever she's out in public, like, that's gotta get to you. That's got to get to you. And I don't know. Just poor Melia. I'm only gonna divulge in the chugga memes, hopefully for the last time right here, but poor Melia. I'm just saying. And so I love Sorean. You know, you have all these different stories where it's so easy to write off all these royalty as just these cruel people, but you have him breaking the mold. Kind of like the king in Final Fantasy XV. Godspeed, you game. I'm so hyped for that. But anyway, that's how I feel about Sorean. That's why that scene just means so much, because I feel like it's one of those cases where they can write and say so much by saying so little. And to me, that's how video game writing should be, even in a game like this where there are so many cutscenes. And I feel like Xenoblade really pulls it off. I feel like it's the peak of its writing is shown in scenes like that between Melia and Sorean. And that's, again, why Sorean is one of my favorite characters. Now, on the note of tragedies, Zanza. Zanza has been introduced. He's going to play a pretty critical role in the things to come. And just him as a being is already filled with so much mystery. The fact that he's a giant, which we have been alluded to when we were doing those side quests over in Zatoral Marsh. Just, so many questions. His interactions with Alvis. The fact that he supposedly, quote-unquote, made the Monado and is responsible for Shulk's visions and all this nonsense. The fact that he has the ability to unbuckle, to release the shackles. That's probably the proper verbiage for the Monado. And finally, allow us to deal damage to the face Mechon, which, as it turns out, is just a blending of Bionis and Menacus? Mechonis. Jesus Christ, I'm already, like, not able to speak. We're already on, like, a really good write. Jesus. You know? Yeah. Face Mechon. It should be noted that, the controller fell asleep. Okay, let's maybe move the camera a little bit from time to time. My bad. Anyway, I'm a mess. My apologies. It's been a while since I've recorded this. Those red lights that we've seen on the Mechon, it has been highly speculated that those aren't just for show, that those actually show, like, blood being pumped throughout the metal body of the faced Mechon shells, which makes sense because, as we know, previously, the Monado was not able... Wow, it's already daytime. Wow. I've already been rambling for a pretty long time. But as we already know, the Monado was not able to cut through any sentient life on Bionis until the moment that the shackles were released, and the idea that it was actual physical blood being pumped throughout that Mechon body, while very gruesome and kind of gross to think about, it makes a lot of sense and will actually be supported even later on in the game. But while we were able to sort of get our revenge on Metal Face, we weren't able to strike him down, but we were able to at least strike him down and hopefully instill at least a little bit of fear into him now that we can finally counter him and fight him, you know, fairly, because we can do damage to him. The bigger reveal, by far, Fiora. You know, some people, when playing through this game for the first time, saw it coming a long way because you don't see her death on screen. I, personally, was one of those people who, I was absolutely just blown away, was not expecting it in the slightest, and, oh, man, you want to talk about a plot twist in a game that just had my jaw, that had me required to scoop my jaw up off the ground. That was definitely one of them. And the fact that she's not recognized the party, like, you gotta think how hard, not only does that have to be on, you know, both Shulk and Ryan, who were her childhood friends, but on Donban, her own flesh and blood relative, like, oh my god. It just, oh, that scene, when they're running after her, when Shulk's screaming out Fiora, just, it tears at my heart, and, well, we have a lot to think about, guys. The stories only get, it's only gonna get even more convoluted and thicker from here, spicier, if you will, so I hope you guys are buckled in, because we are gonna be in for quite a ride. But with that, I believe I've said basically all I've wanted to say, so what do you guys say we go ahead and talk to the anime man himself?
I've been looking for you. So this is where you were.
Shulk. Apologies. Was everyone worried?
Of course. Me especially.
Hmm?
It's just, I've been thinking about Fiora. And I can't help wondering.
Wondering what?
You saw how Fiora acted. It was like she didn't even recognize us.
Yes. It's unsettling. But Shulk, don't get me wrong. I'm not sad. Even if she doesn't recognize me, I'm glad to know she's alive.
Donban.
You see, Fiora was born many years after me. And not long afterwards, we lost our father to a Mekon. It was left to me to protect and raise her, almost like a father.
I was always jealous that she had you as her brother.
Ah, yes. You and Fiora used to be inseparable.
Yeah.
I need to tell you something. I always thought if Fiora were to be with anyone, it should be you.
What? But Ryan hangs out with her just as much as me.
Yeah, he does. But Fiora doesn't like him in that way.
Oh, I see.
He's a nice guy. Reminds me of myself when I was his age. All reckless and hot-headed. Probably why he's not right for her. Listen, Shulk.
Yes?
A lost life can never be returned, but she's alive. It doesn't matter that she's lost her memory.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Fiora and I have spent our entire lives together. The memory of that can't have disappeared completely. It's up to us. We have to help her remember. Help me, Shulk. Help me get her back.
You know I will.
Okay. Let's go tell the others.
Hey, they're back.
Have you gathered your thoughts?
Yes. Sorry to be a nuisance.
Shulk? You too?
Yep. All thanks to Donban.
I'm glad.
Forgive me. His Highness Kalian summons you.
You think something's happened?
We won't know until we get there.
Oh, Donban! Oh! And that scene, too. Ah, I love it so much. It shows, seriously, just how strong Donban is. Not only physically, but emotionally, too. As the beacon that is helping and guiding this entire party, but Shulk especially. You know, Shulk is, in that scene, always said, man, I always wish I had a big brother like you, but, I mean, honestly, Dunban is absolutely showing that he is doing nothing but being that big brother that Shulk needs. I mean, just like with the aftermath of the invasion with Colony 9, instead of grieving about Fiora and being downtrodden, he's not only helping to give advice and consolidate with everyone else who is feeling downtrodden about the events that had taken place, but he's also being a filthy shipper and inspiring Shulk to take action and to go after the girl, and just for so many reasons, and that one especially, I just have nothing but respect for Dunban. Oh, so with that, let's go ahead. Let's have that audience with Kalian.
I apologize for calling you at short notice. It's fine. Is anything wrong?
I must apologize to you all. Forgive our hubris. We High Entia were arrogant enough to idly sit behind our defenses, safe in the knowledge that Mekonis lies a great distance from our land, and we were wrong. Our decision to ignore the Mekon assault on your homeland was wrong.
Your Highness, does this mean...
Yes, Shulk. We will face the dangers ahead together.
Brother!
Which leads me to my request. After setting eyes on a group consisting of Homs, Nopon, and High Entia alike, I realized an allied army must be formed. I ask that you act as ambassadors for the assembly of this force. Tell me your thoughts, Shulk.
I need time before I make a decision.
Does Shulk not wish to aid us in our mission?
I do not believe that to be true.
Then why?
Shulk has other people to consider. That wasn't like you, Shulk.
I'm sorry.
You know you can talk to me.
It's Fiora. That's why you're hesitating.
Yeah.
Knew it. You wouldn't think twice otherwise.
I just don't know.
Find her, Shulk.
Melia,
I used to believe my father did not love me until the day he died. If you do not grasp the importance of loved ones until after they are gone, that is simply too late.
You're right, Melia. I've made up my mind. I'm going to get Fiora back.
You don't have to do this. I'll go and look for her myself. The burden should be mine.
No. I want her back as much as you.
Leave the ambassador stuff to me, Shulk. I'll probably make a mess of it. But we're a team. You can count on me.
I'm afraid that is my duty, Rhyne. I am of both High Entia and Hom's blood. I am the Crown Princess, and of mixed heritage. Thus, I am best suited to carry out this task.
That means we won't...
Yes. I will remain here. We must say goodbye. Is that what you really want? Yes, but promise me, when you find her, you'll come back. I'll be here waiting for you.
I don't know what to say. Thank you. It's probably a good idea if I go and tell Kalian myself.
I am sure he already understands. Besides, it's likely that the ministers are harassing him at this present moment. We should spare him any further inconvenience.
Then, this is goodbye.
Yes. Come back as soon as you can. We are in great need of your help.
Got it.
Why are you still here?
Listen, I'll keep an eye on Shulk for you.
Whatever can you mean?
It's a risky strategy, letting Shulk go off and just hoping he'll come back to you.
Shulk and I are merely...
Yeah, yeah. But remember, the longer he's away, the more chance his feelings for you will fade.
But...
Once we find this Fiora, I will personally whisk him back here in a heartbeat.
Don't give up. I appreciate it.
Great. Don't worry, Melia. I'm on your side.
Brother?
Just on your way out, I see.
It's not what...
I'm sorry, Your Highness. About your offer. We must... humbly decline.
I... see. Very well. Let us hope my sister does not shed too many tears.
I stay because I must, brother.
There's two Melias.
Rhyme wrong. This Melly smell different.
Yes. We need Melia to learn more of the lands of Bionis, but she is still bound to handle public matters. Hence, another Melia.
Kalian.
Your Highness, Crown Princess, as your humble subject, I formally request the following.
Speak.
I request that you accompany Shulk in his quest to find the Mekon that attacked Alkamoth.
Are you sure?
Shulk, I am aware of everything. Go forth and follow your heart. There will come a day when we need you. But it is not today.
Your Highness, that means a lot to me.
That is one cool prince.
If only someone had his sensitivity.
Sensitivity? I'm sensitive.
The jury's out on that one.
That's a relief.
We have recently received a report that the silver-faced Mekon fled to Galahad Fortress, the Mekon stronghold at Sword Valley. It will be a treacherous path. My sister is in your hands.
Thank you, Kalian. I will keep her safe.
Regent, I accept your request. I will return victorious with Shulk.
I am most pleased.
Leaving without me?
Do you want to come?
To reach Galahad Fortress, you will need to travel through Valak Mountain on the right arm of the Bionis. The snow-covered mountains are fraught with danger. Those unfamiliar to them risk never coming back.
Of course, you would be familiar with that region.
Then there's no point in wasting time.
Leave the Allied force to me. I am not known for my diplomacy, but call it pride. I shall succeed.
We'll join you as soon as we can.
I look forward to the day. Heroes of Bionis, make us proud.
You see? Now we're getting some respect.
We're back to this again, are we?
See you soon, Kalian.
Oh man, and they pulled the good old one too. And with that, we also get good old Alvis back in the party. Now, Ryan, I love you. Let's just go with these guys again. I love these three. I feel like they are just very central to this whole arc. But man, when they were like, man, Kalian, what a cool prince. Oh, couldn't have been more correct. Kalian is just best boy. I love him so much. But also that scene between Sharla and Melia. Sharla knowing full well that, Melia's developing them hashtag feels for our Monado boy. It breaks my heart because, guys, I've watched enough anime. I know exactly where this is heading. I don't know if I approve of this love triangle, and I'm just gonna leave it at that. Now, with all that taken care of, with Melia's double in place, allowing her to leave the city of Alkmoth and fulfill her duty of learning more about the Bionis, otherwise known as Kalian just being like, I know you want to hang out with your friends more. We're out.
We will need to traverse Sword Valley if we wish to reach Galahad Fortress.
If Colony 6 were in better shape, we could have taken a pod from there. How are we getting there?
We will take the path down from the Bionis right arm. Sword Valley is where the arm meets the Meconis sword.
Aha. So that's our route.
As I said earlier, it is a snow-covered mountain range, and you should expect a tough climb. Are we all ready?
Ready as we'll ever be.
Quite. First, we will head through Machna Forest. This short-range pod will be our transport. All aboard, people.
Okay, now, you may notice I am kind of moving at, like, lightning pace, but the goal by the end of this video is to, take that pod. Where is it? Oh, it's somewhere around here. You know, actually, while we're doing this, I might as well go ahead and, put on the mini-map once again. Just because I am, I guess, being a little fraud. Oh, there it is. So yeah, our goal is to get over to, Valak Mountain by the end of this video, for reasons, but... Oh man, I'm so excited though. I'm so excited to reach that area because it is one of the best. So, save orders and take you to Machna Forest in this vessel. That's right. So, we're not actually immediately going to Valak Mountain. We are actually going to a different part of Machna Forest. Let's do this, guys. Let's do this. Alright, and we landed. So, yeah, as you can see, hold up, if I pull up the map. So, obviously this is all the area that we had been exploring previously, but now we are off in our own little section that is cut off from the previous ones. Now, I believe if we head over here, there's not going to be too much for us to see, but might as well go ahead and show it off. We also get a pretty cool view, I gotta say, of the canyon. And also, actually, a few areas that we still haven't seen. Whoops, my bad. That's the thing, man. Normally, when I play through this game, I always try to film, like, every area's map, like, 100%, even if I'm not actually able to, you know, do much with those areas. But, obviously, because of this LP, I'm trying to only show things when I absolutely need to go there. But, pretty cool view, right? We also have that quest giver that we're not going to be dealing with for now. But, that does lead me into, once we reach Valak Mountain, guys, we are gonna have, oh god, we are gonna have, I think roughly, if I did the math right, I think we'll have just a little over 90 side quests available to do. Now, I still need to decide, I haven't fully routed it out yet. I'm not completely sure how many of those 90 that we are gonna be taking care of at that point, but we are gonna be having quite a few side quest videos because, man, we've had quite a few old story quest videos. Story videos in a row, but off in the distance, you can actually see, first off, hi there, Suelo, or Lugo. Aside from him, kind of hogging up the picture, what a guy, wow, he's probably gonna wanna pick a fight with us. I do not approve of your ways, although you do have very, very bueno armbands, I gotta say. More important than him, very Latino sounding name, is Valak Mountain, off in the distance. It was in the distance, now I'm not seeing it anymore. What is going on? What is my life? There it is! Valak Pass with mountain just off in the distance.
Zanza is not dead. I feel it. Our tragedy unfolds once again. Lady Maynard, does that mean? Indeed, I do not doubt that Egil too is aware. However, why free the Monado? Zanza must realize it is now a double-edged sword. And what reason could he have for choosing the boy? What is this? I am experiencing feelings for the boy? Lady Maynard. Mayor, your swift repairs are appreciated.
Thank you.
I wish to see that boy again. To meet with the one who wields the Monada.
The boy? But my lady, is that not...
Is Egil aware of my reawakening?
He's not. As my lady wished, he knows nothing.
Then, there is no need to worry. I shall meet the boy. Besides, the Monado will draw him to me.
Flying off without me, huh? I know you from somewhere. Of course, I remember you. You're Gunburn's little sister.
I could go for a hot cup of Dixon's home brew right about now. We're not built for this cold.
It is to be expected. This climate is as different to your home as it gets. It only snows this high up on the Bionis.
Ricky hate cold.
This can't be nice for Ricky. He's from Matna.
A little further down is Sword Valley, right?
Yes. But before then, I must show you something.
Me?
You. Shulk. Do you not see? That tall formation that looks like a tower. Ruins, to be precise.
Ricky see it? Bigger than Big Tree in village.
We can rest there. I'll explain everything then.
I don't know if it's just me or not, but the way that Alvis says, I'll explain everything then, it just sounds really sensual. Am I the only one? Anyway, that's gonna be it for the day. Guys, thank you all so much for watching me play. In the next episode, although I love Valakmound to do you mind? I'm trying to- okay, you know what? Let's just- Even though I love Valakmound to death, that is not going to be the high priority. I just want to get here because it essentially acts as an unlocker for a bunch of different quests throughout the other regions in the game that have come across. In the next episode, guys, we're going to be kicking off even more side quest videos. I'm thinking there's probably going to be at least 6 to 7, possibly even 8, but my goal is to get it down condensed into 6. Either way, we got a lot to cover. Not only sidequest-wise, but also, like, going over this Monado 2. I mean, it is looking pretty dang possum if I do say so myself. I've been rambling on for far too long. So, yeah. We're going to be going over all that and even more. So, again, thank you all so much for watching. And, as always, I'll see you for the next episode of Xenoblade. Bye!